from my city, off from my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. Come on, like the way we rock it, so don't stop. So just dance, dance, dance. I can't stop the feeling. Yeah. So keep dancing.
sounds great.
Recent losses in our state, may it remind us that we must remain ever vigilant in our duty to educate and protect the most innocent among us, our children, our future. In honor of this reverent occasion, we ask that you please respect our students' successes by refraining from noisemakers, air horns, or any other loud distractions that would take away from the solemnity of this dignified ceremony. Additionally, we ask that you silence your cell phones as well. Thank you for your cooperation. And now, let me introduce our student body president, Mr. Aubrey Bond, who will lead us in our invocation.
Let's pray. God, I just want to thank you for this wonderful day and blessing us with this opportunity to come together as a family and as a community to celebrate this joyous occasion. Thank you for the memories that we had throughout our years as students, and I pray that when we take our next step that you will continue to bless us with the strength to overcome obstacles and the grace to forgive ourselves when we fail you for forgiving us. I pray that we be a reflection of your kindness and patience. Thanks for allowing us to graduate, for giving us this opportunity. As we go our separate ways, please bless our travels and our futures. In Jesus' name, amen. Now to present our welcome address is our student body vice president, Bria Branch.
Good evening. On behalf of the class of 2022, I would like to welcome you all to our graduation ceremony. As Dr. Seuss once said, sometimes you will never know the value of a moment until it becomes a memory. With that being said, I would like for all the graduates to cherish every moment from this day on, because as we all know, it goes by fast. High school might have seemed to last a lifetime, however, it was only a moment compared to our futures. We would like to thank the families, friends, teachers, coaches, and administration that all got us to where we are today. Thank you all for being patient and loving to our class of 2022. And now, please stand within preparation for the Pledge of Allegiance led by our Student Council Secretary, Jordan Clark. Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing for the singing of our national anthem, sung by graduating senior Chelsea Orozco.
Ms. Seaman, would you come up here and finish this for us, please?
What so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red. And the home of
Please be seated. I welcome now to the podium our superintendent, Dr. Donnie Lee.
All right, class of 2022, and the parents and teachers that got them here, let's make some noise. Finally here, yes. My name is Donnie Lee, Superintendent of Buna ISD, and it's my distinct privilege to introduce the members of the Board of Trustees who will be presenting diplomas tonight. Please hold your applause until all members have been introduced. Brent Stark, President. Jimmy Branch, Vice President. Matt Buchanan, Secretary. Trustee Ryan Beaver. Joey Broom. Carly Cherry. And Chad Shepard, your Buna ISD Board of Trustees. Thank you. All right, seniors, I'm going to share three pieces of advice in the next 10 minutes or so that I wish I had had when I graduated 25 years ago today. Number one, success is never on sale. I'm going to repeat that again. Success is never on sale. It's never on discount, but they got discounts on good. They give away average, and okay is always in the clearance bin, but success is never on sale. It's hard to get. You have to work at it. Success takes time in whatever form you define success. Spiritual success, family, friends, college, relationships with your future spouses, job, money, fame, whatever it is, success is never easy to come by. And I always like to give illustration either by music or by sport, two things that bring people together and that everyone can relate to. So my favorite recent example of this came on Saturday, May 7th, when an underdog horse named Rich Strike won the Kentucky Derby. The backstory is just as incredible. Trainer Eric Reed almost gave up horse racing after a 2016 fire destroyed his entire equine center, killing all 23 of his horses. Due to friends and family successfully encouraging him, he decided to continue his dream. Last year, he purchased Rich Strike for $30,000 as a throwaway horse. Nobody wanted him. But Reed and his jockey continued to ride and train every single day. Even on selection day for the Derby, Rich Strike wasn't selected as one of the 20 horses to race. However, one day before the race, a horse was injured and scratched, and Rich Strike found his way into the Derby at a 99-1 underdog. By the time the bell rang, his odds to win the race were 80-1. He trailed far behind the entire race until the final furlong, where he exploded down the backstretch, narrowly beating the betting favorite. An incredible testament of resilience and making the most of your opportunity. Success didn't come cheap. Number two, listen to these three words. And I challenge my staff with these every year. These are the most powerful three words you're going to hear in a while. They are, do your job. Do your job. Implied but not stated in those three words is the word well. Notice I didn't say do their job or worry about their job, worry about your neighbor or your classmate's job. Do your job. Focus on yourself because your time is limited. Don't waste living someone else's life, and don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. One of the greatest sports examples of this occurred in the game of basketball. Did you know that only 3% of high school basketball players go on to play in college? That's it. Did you know that 1% of that 3% are drafted into the NBA? That's how hard it is to make it to the professional level. It's even harder to stay there. Yet, in 1996, a player who averaged 5 points per game not only signed a contract extension, but was given a $6.5 million raise and played 4 more seasons. How is that even possible? To average that amount of points, get a huge raise, and stay longer? The answer is, he did his job. Dennis Rodman played for the Chicago Bulls for 3 seasons and led the NBA in rebounds every single year while also capturing 3 NBA championships. His job wasn't to score points. It's Michael Jordan's job. His job wasn't to score points. That's Scottie Pippen's job. His job was to rebound, and he did it in the best in the NBA. For most of you, your job, as I looked on that wall out in the high school, I looked at your picture on the hall, in the hall, up on that big wall, in the main building, and I read every single one of your future occupations or what you hope to do. And so for many of you, your job will be going to a junior college or university. A job well done will be to wake up on time, get to class, study, earn good grades, make the dean's list, and graduate. Yet, by those standards I just told you, only 3 out of 10, or 30%, do their job well. The other 70% never graduate college. Future college students, do your job. For some of you, your job will be to hone your skills as a welder through trade school. This includes that there are no cracks or holes in the bead, as uniform waves, width, height, and meets the required strength. 53% of prospective welders finish school and are able to provide for their families. Our prospective welder graduates, do your job well. The job of 4 of you will be to protect the greatest country on earth through your service in the United States Armed Forces. Protect her from attacks, both foreign and domestic. Like I talked about earlier, have a laser focus on successfully improving your abilities and your skills. Be great, not good. Good is the enemy of great. Don't be average, and by doing so, you will do your job well. I'm going to end with number 3, with the story of the Chinese farmer. Some of you may have heard it. Some of your parents may have heard it. There was a man in the village who had a horse, and the horse ran away. All the people in the village came to him and said, "We're so sorry. We can't believe your horse ran away." And his comment back was, "Well, maybe." The next day, the horse that had run away, it had returned, and along with it brought 10 other horses with him. All the people in the village came running to the Chinese farmer and said, "This is unbelievable. You should be so happy. You thought you lost one, and now you have 11 horses. The Chinese farmer said, "Well, maybe." He had a son, and when they were taming these wild horses, his son was riding one of these new wild horses, and he got bucked off the horse and broke his leg. And all the people in the village came running to him and said, "Oh, I'm so sorry that your son broke his leg." And the farmer said, "Maybe." The next day there was a war, and they were coming to draft the young men, and they came to his house for his son. But his son can't go to battle in the war because his leg is broken. All the village people came and said, "What a blessing. He doesn't have to go off to war." And the farmer said, "Maybe." The point is, seniors 2022, you do not have the perspective of what is going to happen in the future. You cannot connect the dots looking forward. You can only connect them looking backwards. Some things that you think are great may not be so great years later. Maybe they will. Maybe they won't. The same is true in reverse. Some things that you think are bad, such as losing a job, a bad breakup, or any other things that is going to happen to you as soon as you graduate and walk across the stage, may not be so bad after all. Maybe they will. Maybe they won't. Time will tell. The future will tell whether or not the history of the past was good or bad. Seniors 2022, don't just make a living, make a difference. God bless and good luck to you in your next season of life. God bless. Now your 2022 salutatorian.
Good evening and welcome. If you don't know, my name is Tali Rawls, and I'm the salutatorian of the graduating class of 2022. To start, I would like to say a huge thank you to all of our teachers, coaches, administration, principals, staff, family, and friends that played a part to get us here tonight. It might not have been easy, but we're graduating because each and every one of you supported us, whether that be in school, in the classroom, or even at home. I would also like to thank everyone that played a part in my life and pushed me to be my best self. It took a village to get me here, and y'all know who you are. To my dad, thank you for always giving me a confidence boost. Without confidence, I definitely could not be here today. To Oren, thank you for your constant advice in all things that happen in my life. Growing up is hard, but our talks definitely make it easy. And to my mom, I can never thank you enough for believing in me and supporting me in everything I do. You truly are amazing, and I will always count on you. To the class of 2022, as high school ends and we start the next chapter of our lives, I hope that we never forget the memories that lay within our school, our class, and Buna as a whole. It's fun to look back on elementary school and remember how almost every single one of us had our own house made of pine straw, or the dreaded music programs and the horrible eye station tests we had to take for reasons I still don't know. We all learned how to basically spend money through Cougar Cash and even how to save it. Elementary was fun, but as we moved into junior high, we got what we thought was real freedom. We could choose our classes and had more options for lunch, but we also had to deal with some difficult teachers and face the embarrassment of getting dropped off in front of the entire school, which is terrifying if y'all didn't experience that. Junior high had many ups and downs, but we pushed through together. In high school, we got to explore our other interests more closely, whether that was being involved in FFA, athletics, art, band, nursing, or any other club that we devoted our time and energy to. The opportunities seemed endless. We went through big life changes together, like getting our driver's license, which might have caused a few wrecks. We went through good, bad, sad, and even drama-filled times. I could bring up COVID, but I think we've heard enough about that to last a lifetime. We've had to adjust, whether that be taking hard classes, changing principals, and whether or not to wear masks. However, we made it through, and finally we were seniors. Senioritis hit most of us during the first semester, but we pushed through and now we're here. In a few short moments, we'll be officially graduated and ready to start the rest of our lives. Most of us will be going our separate ways, but my wish for our class is to always remember where you came from and the people that shaped you to be who you are today. Thank you, class of 2022, for the memories and the years that we have shared together. I will miss all of you, and I wish you all the very best. Thank you, God bless, and giggum always. Allow me to introduce our valedictorian, Katie Chambliss. Good evening, and congratulations to the graduating class of 2022. Before we begin tonight, I would like to thank a few people who have made this accomplishment possible for all of us. To our parents and guardians who guided us every step of the way, thank you. To our teachers and administrators who taught us that knowledge is infinite as well as entertaining, thank you. To our friends who made school bearable as well as enjoyable, thank you. And last but not least, I'd like to personally thank three of the greatest influences in my life. My family, whose encouragement and support has enabled me to stand here today. My band directors, who gave me my love and passion for music. And my twirling coach and friend, Miss Patsy Collier, who taught me to always strive for the best version of myself, even if it is the more difficult path. Now, if everyone would join me in giving these amazing influences a round of applause. Thank you. Today we stand on the precipice of our future. We're now starting this next chapter in our lives with a clean slate and a plethora of opportunities. Some of us may go on to college, others trade school, the military,
or even straight into the workforce. Just remember that whatever path you decide to take, you are the only one that decides your future. With hope, hard work, and dedication, all of our goals for the future are possible. You can get into your dream college. You can have that job that you've always wanted. You can do anything you want if you just believe and dedicate yourself to your goals. Jane Goodall once said, "What you do makes a difference." And you have to decide what kind of difference you want to make. You want to look on your, when looking back on your life, you don't want to have regrets and be disappointed in the person you chose to be. So surround yourself with those who will encourage your dreams and support you along the way. You want to look at your life and be proud of everything you have accomplished so far. Be proud of the person you have become. You have the opportunity to make the world whatever we want it to be, because we are the future. I'd like to leave you tonight with the famous words of Dr. Seuss. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. Thank you and congratulations once again to the graduating class of 2022. And now Dr. Lee and Mr. Club will, oh, am I supposed to read that? Okay. Those, okay. Thank you.
At this time, Mr. Club will recognize and certify the Buna High School graduating class of 2022.
Buna High School class of 22, please stand. As principal of Buna High School, I hereby certify that these graduates of the class of 2022 have met the requirements of the Texas Education Agency and the Buna Independent School District. And Dr. Donnie Lee, I present to you the class of 2022.
Based upon the presentation by Mr. Club that the class of 2022 candidates have satisfactorily completed all the requirements of the TEA and of the Buna Independent Schools District, I hereby certify that the Buna High School class of 2022 is eligible for graduation, having satisfactorily completed all requirements. Ms. Sherman, please approach the podium to recite the names of our graduates.
You may be seated. First row, please stand. Braxton Harold Adams. Ashlyn Rose Aguilar. Caitlin Ray Anderley. Carly Marie Bear. Carrie April Beasley. Madison Grace Beasley. Aubrey Perry Bond. Logan Dwayne Boyd. Bria Elizabeth Branch. Kelsey Nicole Brandon. Caleb Anthony Breedlove. Cade Wesley Brinkman. Cassidy Elaine Briscoe. Jack Michael Broughton. Gage Scott Brown. Abby Blair Burt. Sebastian Connor Caputo. Isabella Francisca Beatrice Caputo. JC Lynn Riley Casty. Katie Lynn Chambliss. Rayleigh Ann Chance. Jordan Taylor Clark. Rayleigh Colleen Bell Clark. Wendy Alicia Clark. Keegan Reed Curry. Maya Diana Davis. Haley Alexis Dawson. Bryson Eugene Durr. Faith Laney Dixon. Ariana Madison Elliott. Ashlyn Nicole Everett. Yes! Kaylee Cheyenne Farney. Gabriel Alexander Franklin. Brent Charles Fry. Daylon Hunter Gilchrist. Chelsea Nicole Gore.
Yes, go Chelsea.
Dylan Reese Graffanino. Caitlin Danae Grisham. Aubrey Nicole Diamond Harding. William Race Hatch. Colby Blaine Hawthorne. Caleb Dalton Helm. Maria Lulu Hernandez Cisneros. Herman Abarbia Larinaga. Levi Allen Isaacs. Asia Joycelyn Jackson. Joshua James Kelly. Colton Kyle Kibido. Karen Lynn King. Mackenzie Renee Latham. Braden Elijah Lewis. Laith Robert Lanyon. Richard Lynn Levere. Madison Mackenzie Lynch. Chloe Lynn Marks. Gerald Dwayne McAnally. Mackenzie Claire McDonald. Jacob Rice McQuarrie. Rachel Arwen Midkiff. Tyler Christian Milstead. Georgia Minato. Colin Kirksey Morgan.
Oh yeah, Colin!
Logan Matthew Moss. Cheyenne Marie Nash. Chelsea Jolene Orozco. Haley Joanne Louise Palmer. Haley Danielle Pate. Hollis Dean Westcott Peach. Ty Jacob Permenter. Love you, Molly. Michaela Daisy Pivato. Natalie Rose Pivato. Cheyenne Mahala Pierce. Aiden Chance Quillen. Tylee Elizabeth Rawls. Trinity Rhiannon Noel Renfro. Elena Leanne Richards. Joshua Caden Robinson McCain. Dylan Marvin Rogalski. Ashton Lee Sanford. Ja'Cameron Rashan Schenkel. Ja'Kevion Rashad Schenkel. Bridget Alexandra Shepherd. Colton McCright Travis Smith. Zarin Taylor Smith. Delaya Shirai Spikes. Kyler Michael Stark. Katie Lee Stout. Bellin Brandon Uribe. Mackenzie Ann Uribe. Derek McQuill Watts. Jurius Ajante Westbrook. Hayden Payne Wilkinson. Christopher Michael Willie. Ashley Leanne Williams. Dosha Marie Williams. Nash Winton Withers. Isaac Edward Woodward. At this time, Senior Delegate Kyler Stark will lead us in a final word of prayer.
Please bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for our time here together, for all the friends we have made in the days of laughter and fun, for all the times of learning and preparation that we will use for the rest of our lives. We thank you for giving us the energy and skills so that we may graduate today. Our teachers and mentors, our families and loved ones, we thank you for everyone that's been with us on this journey. As this chapter in our lives closes, another one opens. We pray you watch over us and your will be done. We ask in your glorious name of Jesus, amen.
Seniors, please rise and stand together one final time. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduating class of Buna High School 2022.